Respected President of India, Chief Pranab Mukherjee, my colleague in Ministry, Dr. Charandas Mahant, distinguished recipients of the Cooperative Excellence Award, Secretary, Ministry of Agriculture and Cooperation, Chief Bhaguna, Chief Paldiwal, Managing Director of the NCGC, ladies and gentlemen, being the Minister of Agriculture and Cooperation, I'm extremely happy to be here to participate Golden Jubilee celebration of NCGC and for confirming NCGC Award for the Cooperative Excellence for the Cooperative Societies from different states. I must begin my address by congratulating the award-winning Cooperative Societies. Their outstanding performance is being duly recognized today. We hope that they will continue to deliver even better results and promote the cooperative philosophy and principles. I also take this opportunity to exhort all the cooperatives in this country to work tirelessly and selflessly in their respective areas and aspire to join the rank of the award winners. The role of the cooperative as an agent of change in bringing about the betterment in the life of especially the weaker society in both rural and urban India is extremely significant. I note with happiness that NCGC has completed 50 years of the distinguished service to the cooperative sector. To add to the significance of Golden Jubilee, I also note that this is the International Year of the Cooperation as declared by United Nations. The notable contribution of the NCGC over the last 50 years through the financial assistance to the many cooperatives on a sustainable basis has helped professionalism, the sector itself, and we are confident that the NCGC will continue their excellent work. If the cooperative sector is truly become a transformational force for the rural society, then it must above all function professionally. Day by day, our efforts are to support more cooperative institutions financially. Last year, NCGC's disbursement was ₹5,008 crores. And I'm extremely happy when I see the recovery figure, recovery percentage of last year is 99.98%. And this year, we have taken decision to sanction 7,082 crores, and this disbursement will be in different types of societies, like fisheries, dairies, cooperative sugar, cooperative textile, handloom, and many others. Friends, it is well recognized that agriculture, even if its share of the total GDP is declining, is the mainstay of our economy, since it provides sustenance and livelihood to over 600 million of the country. It is also recognized that the key to the rural emphasis lies in making agriculture and allied activities economically viable. This requires improvement in productivity, post-harvest management, and much more efficient supply value chain. As the agriculture productivity and production increase, additional storage and cold storage capacities must keep pace. So also, intermediation between the farmer produce and final consumption must become more efficient. For all these, cooperatives are ideally placed. And NCGC, our premier cooperative financial institution, has a distinct and well-defined role to play. In this view, the nomination of the NCGC as the accreditation agency of warehouse by the Warehousing Development and Regulatory Authority is timely and welcome. This will help our cooperative better appreciate the requirements of the modern supply and value chain and organize themselves accordingly. Looking back, we must acknowledge that the cooperative system, which provides all manner of support services for the farming, has been a key part of the agriculture sector. Over the years, the cooperative movement has grown to over 6 lakh strong, making its presence felt from village to national level. With a membership base of 250 million, Indian cooperative movement is the largest in the world. Its share in fertilizer distribution is 35%, and sugar production is nearly 46%. Dairy cooperative have to their credit the white revolution, which has made India completely self-sufficient in the milk and dairy products. Indeed, the cooperatives in our country are playing a vital role across the sector of our growing economy. A major initiative taken recently is the 97th Amendment of the Constitution, effective from 15th of February 2012. This is designed to ensure democratic, autonomous, and professional functioning of the cooperative, and has made the right to form cooperative society as a fundamental right. In addition, the government has announced a national policy of the cooperative to encourage cooperative and enable them to work as autonomous, self-reliant, and democratically managed institutions accountable to their members. NCDC has played a key role since its establishment in March 1963 under the Act of the Parliament for planning and promoting the countrywide program of the cooperative activities and the cooperative principle of the production, processing, marketing, storage, export, and import of the agricultural products and other sector. Till date, it has provided around 36,000 crore as a financial assistance to the cooperative sector. Never before have been need for the restoring confidence of the people in the cooperative sector been felt so much to achieve the goal of inclusive development. In this context, the issue of good governance has assumed importance as a large number of the cooperatives are experiencing serious problems like mismanagement, financial impropriety, growing distance between the member and management, and weak resources base. Thus, there is an urgent need to revamp the cooperative institutions to work as autonomous and professional cooperative organizations accountable to the members, to be managed by members themselves. The NCDC Award for the Cooperative Excellence, instituted in year 2002, is an initiative to promote and recognize those cooperatives which are able to demonstrably benefit their members, overcoming all odds. Today, we are honoring 27 cooperative societies. We have honored 27 cooperative societies, including 3 at a national level, spread all over the country and covering the wide range of the economic activities. We hope that these awards will inspire them to even higher performance and show the way to the other cooperatives. Before I conclude, I would like to thank Honorable President of India to give his valuable time today. His presence here symbolized the importance of the cooperative sector in the country. I conclude by extending my best wishes to the NCDC and all cooperatives, and hope that together we shall take the cooperative movement in our country to even greater heights. Thank you very much.
Bahut bahut dhanyawad, Maniye Shri Sharad Pawar ji. हमारी अब आपसे अनुनय है माने श्री शरद पवार कि कृपया एनसीडीसी कॉफी टेबल बुक और कॉरपोरेट फिल्म की सीडी रिलीज करें अपने कर कमलों द्वारा और इसकी एक एक कॉपी माने राष्ट्रपति जी को भेंट करें. कॉफी टेबल बुक एक आईना है एनसीडीसी के कामयाब सफ़र का कि किस तरह से एनसीडीसी ग्रामीण अर्थव्यवस्था को मजबूत बनाने में कारगर सिद्ध हुआ है. और एनसीडीसी कॉरपोरेट फिल्म सहयोग कैप्चर्स विविडली द कमेंडेबल एफर्ट्स एंड एक्टिविटीज अंडरटेकन बाय द कोऑपरेटिव्स.